Wanaka is such a beautiful place at this time of year. I was there yesterday, spent the day talking to people, caught the plane out at the airport. Briefly crossed my mind that wouldn't it be nice if I could get Easter trading sorted in time for next year's Warbirds over Wanaka. I will keep working on that issue with my members' bill to get some sense into Easter trading legislation. But I guess the main thing about Wanaka yesterday was that I popped into the Salvation Army to see how they were getting on, and also into the community network rooms where I hold my constituency clinics. That's where I see people who, you know, might need my help with something. And it's interesting that there are a number of people who have fled Christchurch after the earthquake, have gone to Wanaka. They've gone to lots of places throughout the lower half of the South Island in my electorate, but Wanaka, there are people who are requiring help. So I'm setting up a system where I've got contact between Nikki Wagner's office in Christchurch, my office, which is mostly based in Oamaru, but I'm also making sure that extra staffing time goes into Wanaka so that we can help where we can with people from Christchurch. So it shouldn't be underestimated the impact that the earthquake is having on people throughout the South Island. It's not just happening in Christchurch. There is real need outside of Christchurch. And so I'm doing what I can, and my staff are doing what they can to help people who find themselves, you know, without the basics, without clothing and without food and without somewhere to live and having to cope with high rents, looking for work. So where we can fill the gaps for, you know, bridging the gaps between people and government departments and getting the assistance they need, I'm putting extra resources into that. So it's a satisfying part of my staff's work, and they work really hard to help people in that way, and so, you know, I'm pretty happy about that.